I'm Linda Kemp, and I'd like to show you an alternative approach to painting. Whether you're an accomplished artist or just starting out, I'm sure you'll find negative painting intriguing. It's a fun way to create beautiful watercolors. First, let's begin by looking at the difference between working in the negative and the more usual positive way. In this illustration, you can see on the left-hand side the typical or usual additive approach, or working in the positive. On the right-hand side, you'll see the negative approach. The negative space is shown in black. Positive and negative share the same edge. One can't exist without the other. It's a simple shift in the way that you visualize. No matter how expertly you apply paint to paper, you're not capable of actually making a tree or a rock or flowers. What we do is create symbols that represent these things. In the top row, you'll see the positive symbols for a house, a bike, a tree, and a little couch with a lamp. This is the usual way that you create things in the positive. Positive is shown in the black. In the lower section, you see the same symbols, but this time they're shown in the negative. The negative space is depicted in the black. In between the shapes are captured negatives. So between the spokes of the wheels, where you see the little triangles, that's a captured negative space. They're what give us information and make a more interesting symbol.